And Nightstalker is a reasonably strong support. You can also put him in a three position. So you've got a little bit of variability right there. It leaves your draft a little bit open. They can't just target ban out certain positions of heroes yet. So, I mean, I think it's fine. I think it's definitely a little odd. You don't usually see him in the first phase. He's turned into more of a second phase sort of hero. But, you know, if they want to play a Nightstalker, who am I to stop him? Here's great.
Yeah. He is just fantastic, especially as a support. And against Slardar, I actually think he's really good. He's got that nice burst nuke of the Void, and also the Silence, just to stop Slardar from really adding to a fight. Because we talked last night when we saw Slardar about how amp damage is a lot of what he brings to the fight, and you get other heroes to supplement that damage. If he can't cast any spells, well, there's not much he can really do.
You'll probably have a better target for a Silence than Slardar, but the Pain sneaks through to the second phase again. We've been seeing this a lot, actually. She's been hanging in kind of the second phase of bans in the South American games we've been doing recently. Now she even sneaks past it as a second phase pick. I think that's incredibly valuable a lot of the time. I mean, so I think I saw that article you were talking about. Navi linked
it. Navi Gaming,
about,
yep.
Yeah, they linked it about pick position of various heroes. And we saw, actually, that Queen of Pain in the first phase was actually having a pretty poor win rate overall. I think she was sub 50%. But if you can get her this late and Tusk, how do you get Tusk in second phase?
I have no idea. Maybe if Shadow Fiend and AA and, for some reason, Clockwork get banned. I'm not too sure about the Clockwork ban.
Reserve time.
He's been popular in the past, don't get me wrong, but
Clockwork is incredibly frustrating for Slardar.
Okay, yep, you're right. I didn't think about it that way. And so it is kind of a pocket ban if you have a Slaughter on the team.
It can be. I mean, obviously some teams are going to be more comfortable dealing with it than others. Clockwork really frustrates a lot of melee cores because all he has to do is get a force staff, call command, and then laugh.
Ooh.
Okay.
That's into a Slaughter?
Yeah. What? I mean, obviously Virus has a plan for this. Don't get me wrong. They think they know what they're doing.
Now,
no drafter goes into a game and says, I'm just going to pick Huskar fourth pick, even if
that's just random.
Let's just do it. No one does that, except maybe Ice Ice Ice. He might be trying to troll us like that.
Ice 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 would be one to do it, for sure. But against the Darkseer, I will say Huskar is a hero who can lane against Darkseer just fine. I mean, he's ranged, and even if he gets the Ion Shell up in his face, he's got that magic resistance to work with. But Broodmother and Anti-Mage, the final bans out here, they really don't want to deal with a lot more physical damage coming from Tisho, but I think they'll be able to find it somewhere.
I really don't like the Huskar. Like, I mean, even before the Bane got picked, I don't like it against the Slardar. I don't like it against the Tusk. I think it's too easy to dodge Life Break on heroes with Snowball, and Walrus Punch is, of course, a lot of physical damage. Ice Shards can lock him in. Once he Life Breaks too far out, people can't get in to help him, and now you have the pure damage finisher from the Bane. 300 pure damage is pretty easy to finish off Huskar with.
Reserve time.
There's just so many good ways of dealing with that hero, and I don't like him in the fourth pick position in general. But, like I said, Virus thinks they know what they're doing. So, I'll reserve judgment until I see the lanes, until I see how they work it.
Yeah. Now, one thing to point out is Tisho has been very upfront with their picks. They've answered almost instantly to all of Virus's picks and still have all their reserve time to work with. So, if this is going to be like a fifth pick, pocket pick, oh my god, they just picked Visage as a core or something. They're going to have time to respond to it and kind of figure it out, hopefully. So, it will be Ember Spirit, though. Now, this is a hero who provides another target that Bane wants to lock down. However, it makes Virus Nirvana's lanes a lot more questionable. They could do a dual offlane of Lich Huskar?
Yeah, I think that's what it is. I think it's Lich Huskar offlane, Queen of Pain, Nightstalker, safe lane, with the Nightstalker roaming, because the Queen of Pain is kind of a safe person to throw down there, and Ember Spirit mid. You could also do Nightstalker, Ember Spirit, safe lane, but I think Nightstalker, Queen of Pain is fine too. It depends on how much you want. It depends on what you see your mid matchup as, because we don't have a mid pick for Tisho yet.
Yeah, unless they're going to run something crazy like Tusk mid, which, I mean, it could work, but it's not really optimal, and it's not something they were even really forced into. I mean, Lina's still in the pool. Other mid laners that I'm not thinking of at the moment are still in the pool.
We could just get a last pick Invoker like we got last night.
Yeah. I'm not as big on that one anymore, but it was a fun match. There's no Earthshaker to go up against this time, at least.
Can we get mid Rubick? Huh? Mid Rubick?
That would be quite the throwback.
Go back to TI2?
Yeah. Dindy style? I mean, hey, if we're going Dindy style, why not mid Pudge? Okay. I like this a lot.
Solid.
They were lacking a lot of actual damage to back up the Slaughter, so
It's more.
This will be really nice, yeah.
Off the ultimate, the lightning strikes. So you actually have, so you have one of your supports who plays very nicely off your bonus physical damage, which is the Tusk. The Darkseer actually plays reasonably well off of it, because in the late game you have the Ember Spirit and the Huskar illusions that will be swinging moderately hard.
Yep.
And then, I mean, the Queen of Pain illusion even will swing pretty hard. She tends to scale up moderately well. Not super well,
prepare
but moderately
for
so.
Battle.
And then you just have, in general, good supports for handling the lineup of Nirvana. I do think Tisho has the better draft. I'm not going to be shy about saying that, but I am ready to be surprised by Nirvana here.
Yeah, I do really like the Ember Spirit pick. It is a hero that, against the Darkseer, can kind of go either way, but a lot of his damage comes from that sleight of fist. So it's very important for him to be able to cast abilities. Illusions aren't going to cast abilities, so it is a plus point for their draft, we can say.
Yes, they picked nicely around the Darkseer in terms of their cores.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you still have... It's going to be harder for the Nightstalker to chase people down with Surge available. Same with Huskar. He's going to get the slow on people, and then they can just get surged away, which can be very frustrating. They actually have a lot of slow and not a lot of actual stun.
Yeah.
Darkseer Surge is going to be really, really powerful in this game.
In fact, the only hard stun they have, which isn't even that much of a hard stun, is Searing Chains. Yeah, it's just a root, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, you can still...
And then you've got the mini stun from Lich Ult and Nightstalker's Q. Which, at least you can interrupt CPs, which is good, but on the other hand, you've got, well, pretty much all heroes with some form of interrupt, except for Razor, on the side of Tisho. Speaking of the side of Tisho, though, they're headed up to the top rune. It's going to be, well, right bracket, going into the snowball, up against the Quap. Can they, oh, they missed the crush by just an inch there. It'll be Baga on the Tusk, a very interesting set he's picking up there. ZY will actually be here on the Bane. In the mid lane, it looks like it's going to be CYS, formerly of Jungle's King, and I believe Rebeldez is going to be on that Razor, a very well-known Brazilian player. And last but not least, it's King RD, Wesley Safadão, as he sometimes likes to be called, on the Darkseer.
Okay, we're all going to have some fighting coming down here in the mid lane. CYS dealing a lot of damage, now swinging for plus 49. That was a little greedy by the Ember Spirit to stay in with that Flame Guard. Even with the Lich right there, he's only level 1. He took Sacrifice. All he can do is right-click. You basically just gave CYS the lane until that runs out, because it's not like he can do anything about that.
Yeah, but that's going to secure him a lot of early tempo. So, and it's going to force Lich to use one of his two remaining Tangos. It's not a great start for them.
I know, Lich is the level 1. What are they gonna do? He's just gonna sit here and get all his damage drained again.
Gonna throw some snowballs at him, you know?
I mean, you know, it's frustrating. Razor's base armor actually isn't that impressive for an agility hero. He only sits at 3. So you can actually get a reasonable amount of damage out just by right-clicking, even if Lich's damage is not that great. But you're sapping XP from the Ember Spirit, who's really, really level-dependent. I would almost rather have you somewhere else at the moment. Although Razor... The problem is Razor destroys solo laners, so your Ember Spirit's gonna lose. But at the same time, he's still somehow losing to this Razor with the Lich right there.
Now, meanwhile, Tusk is going to be rotating in. It looks like he has the snowball available, but not going to get in range for it. No smoke used there, so a little bit. And they're just going to have to use Searing Chains to guarantee that he gets those creeps, because the big thing is Ember getting his bottle. Once he gets his bottle, he can survive in the lane. And he can do okay. He can bottle crow back and forth and actually live. Meanwhile, they're going to be looking for the bottom rune, but it looks like we could have a bit of a clash here. King RD on relatively low health. We'll grab a regen rune, and he'll be forced to surge himself, but he is going to run away from the Huskar. Nice snowball coming out from the Tusk there. And it looks like they will live for now. But... Oh, no.
Might be able to get a burning spear. No, Razor's going to come in and shut that down. Just zoning people out with the plasma field.
But a little bit of space made for the Ember Spirit in the mid lane, who is not going to have an easy time in this lane.
Hey, every time you force that Razor out of that lane, you are taking him out of his early game comfort zone. For the first, like, 6 to 8 minutes of the game, or even maybe, like, 10 to 12, until he has a big item, Razor just wants to sit and farm and win the lane.
Now, up in the top lane, we should see Queen of Pain dominate this. While Slaughter does have Slithering Crush, even if he lands it, Quap's going to still be able to blink away until Bane is level 6 and has the Fiend's Grip to hold her down for a little longer. I mean, sure, Nightmare's nice, but you can't really do any damage with it.
I think it depends. I mean, if she sits here and trades hits with the Bane, first of all, you can't trade hits with the Bane. It just doesn't work, because it's just going to brain sap you just like that. once she's out of regen, I actually think she loses this lane quite handily. I mean, you can see Slardar is already getting way more farm out of it than she is, because the Bane actually has shockingly good base damage and HP. Look, he's already got almost 700 HP, swinging for 64. Queen can't trade hits with him at all, even with the added bonus of the Shadow Strike. So that means that he basically sits up there, lowers her down, she's trying to sit in range to get experience while man fighting him. She'll have to run away eventually, and Slardar just sits there and farms. And if she decides to commit, she gets Nightmared, Slithering Crush, she's already like half life.
Nope. And of course, First Blood got missed, but it is going to be the Ember going down. Razor does dive a little bit, and I believe it may have been Searing Chains that killed him off there. Possibly.
It was either Searing Chains or Creeps. Remember that Creeps will give you credit for kill.
Yeah, of course. Or Tower. If you hit them recently enough.
But that's,
so.
I mean, it's totally worth it, not only because he gets more gold out of it, and since obviously it's reliable, so he's not losing any of it, but he's going to get a little bit more of an XP advantage, which is really critical when you're going up against somebody who's got Lich back up.
Yeah. Ember is going to get his bottle out of it, though, and he'll be able to TP back in, as well as getting his boots coming in on the courier very shortly. So he's not missing too much out of it and does get the extra First Blood gold, so that's going to be very nice. Sorry about missing that kill, guys.
I'm just gonna blame it on you, and it's totally
not it is my fault
for, for talking over you at top lane for like a minute about 100%. The lane dynamics. Looks like we do have an invisible Lich hanging out in the bottom lane. Darkseer's very low. Could be in a little bit of danger, but Lich, that end is about half out right now. He only has the level 1 nuke, and he does get bottled up. The Tusk brings him back his bottle. Or rather, fills up his bottle for him on the TP in.
Yeah.
Do they have the nighttime silence, don't they? No, he's only level 2. He doesn't have it skilled.
But with Lich Invis here, they may be able to make something happen.
It's not enough damage.
He'd be able to surge away. Yep. Yeah. Just like that. At least does get the little bit of element of surprise with the regen rune. Or the Invis rune, excuse me. A little surprising, though, that Darkseer goes for that bottle. Any thoughts on that?
I mean, Darkseer in a safe lane, I guess he feels like he might just kind of need it because there's a lot of constant harass coming out, and he doesn't feel like he can use the Soul Ring quite as much. Especially because, you know, with a Huskar, you don't really want to be Soul Ringing yourself for mana to surge.
Not to mention, Razor's not going to be going for a bottle, it looks like. So,
yeah.
The rune is going to be there, likely. And meanwhile, they're looking to go up top. They are going to get a crush out on Quap, but, well, Slaughter in a lot of trouble. He'll get silenced, slowed. And probably taking down Bane there with the Nightmare. And here's the drain from Razor. This is the synergy between Bane and Razor that works so nicely. Bane just Nightmares him, Razor puts the drain, and they just wait.
Oh, I'm not sure this Ember Spirit... Oh, he might get this Slardar right here. Just
he's got it.
Damage. Lich is coming in, though. Razor might be a little bit too deep. Even with the slow coming out from that unstable current, he is going to go down.
Yep.
A little bit too much of a dive there, and a double kill for that Ember Spirit. They had done... I'm not going to say they shut him down very seriously, but he was doing reasonably well. The Razor was doing well against him in the mid lane. Even with the Lich back up, the Razor was winning the lane. And now you just fed him 2 kills. He's 3-1.
It's a very hard lane for the Ember anyway. And now that he's got those 3 kills, he has phase boots or most of a drum done.
He might be going down here.
He's probably dead, yeah. He is going to throw a remnant, though.
He's got some charges. They're not enough.
Unfortunately, he can chains, but they were still in range, unfortunately, and that Frozen Scissor just doing so much work. I don't even recognize this set on the Tusk, but it is, it's
really
quite a
like
nice one.
Sigil, the, like, Lion Sigil, that's dope.
Oh, it's the one from the Fall Compendium.
Okay.
So, like, no one has it unless you've won tons of your coin bets. Anyways, the last is going to be, well, the first to fall in this bot lane, as Darkseer does manage to take him down. Huskar's doing okay, though. He's actually almost up to an armlet in about 450 gold. So that's going to be very nice for him to work with.
It's a good start, yeah. I mean, it'll let him go a little bit ham. Obviously, you want your Huskar to be applying a lot of pressure. He's not your late-game carry. You put him in your 3 position. You're giving the Ember Spirit plenty of space. So what he wants to do, I mean, the Ember Spirit has done what he needed to do in this mid lane, which is get enough farm that he can transition to a harder farmer while the Queen of Pain and the Huskar make space.
Yeah.
I'm still curious to see how well this Huskar does when he starts fighting, though. That's my biggest worry for the side of Nirvana, is there's so many good ways to deal with him. Even if it's just a Nightmare, if you go on him and you don't have a way to kill him, Nightmare him and run away.
Yeah, it is a nice way to isolate a hero out of the fight. I'm a little surprised Bane hasn't gone for a point in Enfeeble, but then again, I'm not a very
He hasn't
good
really
Bane
been
player.
Sitting in lane as much. The only okay. person he was sitting in lane against was the Queen of Pain, and the best thing you can do if you're just trading hits with someone is... I mean, so if they're not going for last hits themselves,
yeah.
so you don't have to worry about that, you'd rather have more points in Brain Sap.
Yeah, because you're going to be able to harass more efficiently when you
and
take into account
the
heal.
Take out of Nightmare to do that. I mean, maybe that would be worth it. It's only one less second, but the extra cast range is nice, and it gives that Slardar one extra second to get in for the stun if you decide to go on somebody.
The cast range is really the big thing there, because you can initiate and you can make those saves from a long way away, and they want to do both with this lineup. I mean, with the Razor combo, that's going to be very efficient. I'm a little surprised Razor hasn't picked up his ult yet, but here we go. Yep, the ward will catch it out. They're going to get the silence off, but there is a drain coming out from Razor. They'll be able to bring down the Huskar, and a Nightmare here will hold him down with the Fiend's Grip as well, and it looks like Nightstalker's going down too. That's a double kill for CYS. He's sitting on 1,400 gold right now, and I would, yeah, he's definitely the top net worth. 4K gold.
They saw them start moving when, like, about when they got to here. They saw the heroes that were right here start kind of moving away, or moving into them, rather, to try and fight. So they know that the ward is right there. They can get rid of it. Unfortunate that it's not really that much of a D ward. It's only got, like, a minute left on it. But hey, it's still something. Cut off some of that vision. Put the fear of God into him.
Yeah. Now, I mean, they may not have a problem with vision late game if Nightstalker gets his Ags, but they will slow down the Razor, who, well, in turn slows down Nightstalker a bit. This is one of the heroes that's good against Nightstalker for that reason. But here comes Ember, doesn't quite get in range, and now there's a Nightmare. Unfortunately, though, they miscoordinated on the target and won't get that nice combo. Yeah, it's still fine. But you could also just get so much more off that and then still have enough room to go in. So, looks like they need a moment to pause. Probably just, lag, you know. Just South America things.
That Razor change where it drains the damage like every quarter or half second instead of once every second is so big. It was so frustrating to wait, and it's like, you know, if they get woken up at like 1.8 seconds and get out of range, you'd only get one tick off of that drain. It's so much nicer now. You can actually watch just how fast it ticks up. Click on him when he's got that going and watch it go like tick.
I'll try
tick,
to
tick,
do
tick.
It.
It's actually incredible.
I've played a little bit of Razor since the patch, but not too much, because I'm not very good at Razor, but I'm not very good at most heroes, so, hey. They are going to go after Quap, it looks like.
This Queen of Pain has been already pretty brutally shut down. I don't think she can afford to die much more. She's just getting her treads at 10 minutes as a safe lane farmer.
And that is definitely rough.
They didn't really do a lot to create space for
her.
There
they go.
Snowball.
Nice blink away, though. Just
didn't quite get it.
I'm guessing seeing the... Oh, wait. She's got ult.
Here. She might get to blink out.
Nope,
still on cooldown, level 1.
Oh, and she leveled her scream, so wasn't even able to get the damage out. Now here comes Nightstalker, and actually that courier could be in a little bit of trouble. He'll be okay. It's still daytime, so Nightstalker's actually doing okay. Or less okay in terms of move speed, excuse me. Meanwhile, on the bot lane, it looks like CYS wants to go in on Huskar, who is going to get Fiend's Grip. He's dead.
Just so much physical damage. So much damage. Even with the extra armor from the Lich in the late game, it's still going to be very, very difficult to keep him alive.
Yeah, not to mention that if you're getting hit by the Eye of the Storm, which will hit the lowest health target in the AoE, which generally is going to be a Huskar, it's going to remove one armor every time it hits. So, you've got Frost armor, but that's just kind of making up for the armor you've lost at that point.
I mean, even then, I mean, the amp damage is already going to trump the frost armor, but you do, Dyer's trust me, there's nothing wrong with getting some frost armor when there's a Slardar against you.
Oh,
that's
definitely.
A very valid pick.
I don't think there's ever anything wrong with getting a frost armor. I like to go kind of 2-1-2 on Lich, but I very rarely play him.
The prevalence of heroes like Tusk and Dazzle make plus armor much, much more valuable in this meta.
Yep.
Just because there's so much physical damage coming off a lot of the commonly picked supports and offlaners.
I mean, just in general, Slaughter is being picked up first pick almost every game. Like, he's not strong enough to be banned out every game now, but he's at least getting picked. So, picking up heroes like Lich can be very good as a defensive kind of deterrent there. Attack. Same with the Dazzle.
How long do you think it's going to be before we start seeing first phase banned Slaughter? Because I think it's coming.
Very soon.
I think teams are going to get really tired of it.
I wouldn't be surprised to see it next game after the trouble they've had. Now, nice... Searing Chains there to grab the Bounty Rune and get away. Razor's going to find himself a Haste Rune, though, and it looks like he's going to make it away bot until he runs into the Huskar. And that is at least a kill for the Huskar. We've kind of bashed on this Huskar a bit, but he is sitting on an armlet and 1,000 gold.
Uh-oh. Nope. The chains. He's dead.
This is great for Nirvana right now. Things are looking really bad for them, but Huskar getting 2 kills now is going to put him 400 from a helm. And once he's got armlet helm, this is a hero, suddenly. It's not just a, oh, well, I have some burning spears.
So he's a hero now. What was he before? A ranged creep with a really frustrating dot?
A ranged creep with a dot, yep.
But what, does Life Break not do anything, Revo?
It just lets him jump. It lets the ranged creep jump toward the tower a little faster, you know?
So it's a barbarian ranged creep.
Yeah. It's a manly ranged creep. Right. Normal ranged creeps just slowly walk to feed. This one jumps.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. Okay, so things slowing down a little bit. They do pick up that point in the frost armor. Hopefully no sniperino going on here. And it looks like there is gonna be... Well, it's a magic wand picked up for the Lich. I was thinking he was going for a medallion here, which is gonna be very useful for them in the mid-game. Question is, can Tusk get to his first as Smoke is going to be broken? Ember's a little out of position here, but I believe he has a remnant. However, Fiend's Grip is going to keep him down. ZY now on a killing spree. They'll take down Lich as well. Huskar, you got to run. This is not the fight to take if you can handle it, but Snowball coming off cooldown. Still set 6 seconds to go, so he should be fine.
Yeah, I mean, he's out of range anyway. They are going to get this tower for free, though.
Yeah, just sending Razor around, and actually, this is a disaster. Does he realize? He sees him here. They're going to realize a little too late. As Quap throws out a dagger, can they do enough here? One more hit might have brought down Huskar with that armlet off, but they will just give up the tower and back off for now, which I think is what they had to do. A very nice smoke gank from Tisho, but...
Razor drained 140 damage. They absolutely had to back off.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
So, Ember Spirit just trying to get his farm going, instantly TP's back to mid lane, he wants to get some pressure going, Slardar is there, he doesn't have a blink dagger, he's gonna put on that amp damage, just say, you know what buddy, if you wanna stick around, my friends will be here for you.
Is under yeah, attack. And he actually goes for treads over tranquil boots, which is what we've been seeing on, Slardar, and meanwhile, Razor getting jumped in, they will actually keep draining him through the snowball, didn't know you could do that, but, yeah, that's 175 damage. Lich ult will not bring down anyone. And Quap is stuck in the middle here. No blink available. This is an outright disaster for Nirvana. They're going to lose everybody.
So, you remember how I said that Life Break was really frustrating because of how good Snowball was against it?
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure I said that.
I wouldn't be surprised if he did, yeah.
Because, I mean, even if you don't dodge the Life Break itself, what you want to do after a Life Break is kill the target you just Life Broke.
Whoa.
Suddenly, if he's invincible and there's a stun rolling towards you, especially if he's stealing all your damage in the meantime, it becomes pretty problematic to be right on top of that hero.
Yeah, and it works the same way that the Bane Nightmare does, as in, yep. You can't stop one or the other from dueling, from draining, sorry.
Yeah.
So, Tisho looking pretty good, 8 kills ahead and about 8k gold ahead, 5k XP. Still, it's not an insurmountable lead, and one thing I always like to bring up with Ember is, if this hero makes it to the late game, there's very few heroes that can contend with him.
That's like, absolutely true.
I've held out against Megas with this hero, I want to say. Like, now, it took 2 rapiers, but, yeah.
Now, hopefully they won't get in that situation where they have to deal with Megas. Nobody wants to be fighting.
Oh, of course.
It's a little early to be predicting that.
Uh-oh.
Like, oh, Ember's going to run to this Razor right here.
He doesn't. Oh, he has a remnant. I was looking at the charge on it, and it was about to expire. If he saw Razor, like, half a second later, he wouldn't have gotten away. So that was really lucky on his part.
It's still frustrating, though, because it means you're getting forced away from your farm just by Razor committing a static link. You have to commit mm-hmm. your defensive remnant to that, and then you can't really farm because of how much damage you've lost. It's not like this is a high-damage Ember Spirit. He needs Flame Guard available if he doesn't have any of that damage.
Yeah, in fact, he's got nothing going for him in terms of damage other than the +4 stats coming from the Magic Wand here.
Yes.
So
he'll get it. He's gone a very farming-oriented build.
Yeah, he's definitely going straight Battle Fury right now, right? Oh, but meanwhile, Slardar is going to be taking down Queen of Pain up top. This Queen of Pain is not having a fun time. In fact, we talked about how she got treads at 10 minutes. Since then, she's gotten a Null Talisman and a Sage's Mask.
That's it. Not exactly the best 7 minutes of farm for you, Queen of Pain.
Not really.
This is where I get to laugh at myself. You remember how happy I was that they got a second phase Queen of Pain? I was like, man, that's value right there. And then, oh, I'm sorry.
And they're smoked up, but they're not going the right way to catch the team. Of course, they know it. They're actually going for Roche here. Wow, Procaster right here, right, Hippie? Do they? They don't?
No, I'm not sure they need it, though.
With Huskar, you can do it with just the armlet and the helm. Assuming you get pretty lucky and don't get bashed to death. Now, with someone here to tank it for you, it's a lot easier. But they are going to have to give up a tier 2 tower for this. I would... almost
I
bet.
It's a trade they have to make, though.
Okay, don't kill the Night Stalker, Roche.
I don't really think they could defend that tower anyway.
Yeah, they're gonna get it.
So getting the Aegis for this is much more valuable.
Especially on the Huskar that really just needs to go in, initiate, do a lot of damage to somebody, anybody, and then die. Also, because they're gonna target him with amp damage, well, if he dies, they have to put another one on him, and that's one less hero that gets amp damage, so...
I mean, amp damage is a 5-second cooldown. You don't really have to be particularly judicious about your use of that ability.
Yeah, but you have to keep in mind, Nirvana wants to take these fights short, if possible. Now, they don't have the liberty of dictating how long these fights are at the moment, but the longer you fight against Razor, the worse your fight is.
That's true if you can't kill the Razor early, yeah, but at the same time, once this Ember Spirit has farmed, they're perfectly happy taking these fights later. I mean, right now, yes, they want to use all their bursty abilities. They don't want to get in a drawn-out fight with the Queen of Pain, because she's got her nukes just fine. But she doesn't have the items she needs to fight.
You gotta run. Oh no, it's an Invis Rune Slardar, and she is so dead.
Oh, Queen. Queen, please.
Dire's structures are fortified.
Drum charge used to speed this up, and you have the Blink Dagger on the Slardar and another 2k gold.
I really like their aggressive use of drum charges here. Like, as soon as CYS got that drum, he's gonna do that. And now that Slardar's got his Blink, he's gonna go Midas. And,
Oh no, I switched it for Medallion.
Okay, I like that a lot better, actually.
Yeah, I mean, that should let him basically solo kill anyone he can Blink on. I don't think there's a hero on that team. Maybe the Night Stalker. Who could live through that, but I think everyone else basically just dies, especially if you get a bash.
In the scenario they're in right now, I'd actually like to see Quap's Nirvana pick up a medallion. You're not going to get anything else with that Sage's Mask pretty much anytime soon, unless it's a Ring of Bassi, and that's not going to do much.
Well, and it would be really late for an Orchid by the time she'd think about picking one up.
Exactly.
See BKBs out. These are really nice BKB carrying heroes. Razor loves BKB. Slardar in the mid game loves a BKB, so you can't slow him down. Oh, Night Stalker's gonna go down right here. The Walrus Punch, actually. Oh, okay, he's gonna get finished off by the Rain Sap right there. Nice vacuum into the wall. A couple heroes getting caught in that. The Drain coming out on the Huskar loses 203 damage. Razor just chewing through heroes like nobody's business. And that should be a very easy tower kill right here. He's got still half of the duration on that damage steal.
Yeah, they will be able to take this down, I believe. Slaughter just gonna blink forward and say, don't touch my carry. He's busy. As that's a Solar Crest done for Slaughter. Now they will grab the Ember. Nice dodge there coming out, and big Quap ult, but is it enough? Ember comes in with a Sleight of Fist. Is it enough? They do lose the Huskar, but that's just the Aegis coming down. Now Razor on the deck, though, and they're gonna look to chase. They keep the tower alive, which is a bit of a miracle here, but without Razor, they know a lot of that damage for Tisho is down. And this is kind of their weak link. I mean, Slaughter does get some hits off, but it's really Razor that's dishing out the big physical damage hits.
Well, they might get this Darkseer. They have the chains. They do. They get both of them. The silence on the Tusk to prevent the snowball. Nice vacuum. Try and keep it away. They're going to jump deep. I'm not sure that's the best move right there to stun right under the tower. Follow up with the Walrus Punch for a dead Huskar. Queen of Pain gets in the screen, but she's taking a lot of damage too. She's stuck behind the ice shards. She's going to go down.
Oh no.
Once more. There goes your Ember Spirit. Oh, the force step forward on the Bane. He's going to get the Nightmare. Slaughter just has to wait for that Slithering Crush. It doesn't matter. Ice Shard's going to set up the kill on that Night Stalker, even without the Razor. Nirvana getting just too greedy on this pursuit. And the Guardian Greaves come up.
Oh.
They can just push right in. The Razor's back up. He's coming in.
They're going to be forced to use a buyback on Ember. Now, he doesn't buy completely out, thank goodness. I mean... It's kind of the thing where you have to do it to keep your towers up, but it may not even keep your towers up at that point. And they've got an amp damage coming in for the Walrus Punch. Lich is dead.
It's getting a little bit out of reach right here.
Ugh.
If they had gotten the Razor and maybe one more and been able to run, that would have been a great little engagement for them, especially since they saved their high ground. But as it is, this is looking very, very vicious for Nirvana.
I mean, you can't ever count them out with the Ember Spirit, but...
I'm not sure
it ain't looking good. Miracles have to happen right now. Like, he has to get somehow a miracle kill that I'm not even sure how he gets. He's still 450 from the Battle Fury.
I don't think it happens.
I mean, I want it to happen, because that would be exciting, but...
I've been wrong before. Oh, the stun on the Ember Spirit. He is okay. Probably going to go down right here. Yes.
No buyback!
CYS. Oh. I mean, well, he had to buy items right there. He could.
But, he could have left the Ring of Health, though. He didn't actually have to buy that out. They do lose the Razor once again, but they've taken Arax with him this time around. And Nirvana just can't stay alive long enough in these fights.
I mean, look at the individual hero net worths, though. You have a 3,700 lead on the Razor over the Ember Spirit. You have a 2,100 lead on the Slardar over the Ember Spirit. Your Darkseer is leading over that Ember Spirit.
There's a Shadow Blade on Slardar, for crying out loud.
The dude's pretty fat. Oh, and he's got a Solar Crest now, not just a medallion.
I
didn't see him pick that up.
He picked it up right as they were pushing the racks, actually, so... I'm going full X-Files here. I want to believe that Ember Spirit can turn this around just to, like, oh my god, look at that game, but... I mean, look at the Slardar at the same time. He didn't even use amp damage. And Lich is dead. Nightstalker is sitting on negative 18 armor when he's amp damage and Solar Crested.
Sounds about right, yeah. Yeah. Makes sense. Balanced hero.
Yeah. Completely fair.
Radiant's bottom
but guys, Solar Crest doesn't go through BKB.
Let's be honest here.
Windrunner.
As far as imbalanced heroes go, I'm okay with Slardar being one of them.
For now. Ice Frog buffs him again, we'll have a talk.
Not sure okay. That's gonna happen.
Oh, I'm pretty sure it's not, but... I mean, look at Undying. He's really strong. Let's nerf him a little, but give him an insanely good axe.
Do we have the Aghanims yet on Razor? No, we don't. He's still one item away from it, so they can't...
We do have a Battle Fury, but...
That's a stun onto the Lich. That's actually really annoying. The Lich ultimate was already down, but not being able to throw that Ice Armor on the tower, on heroes... The Sleight of Fist is coming out from the Ember Spirit, but it's just not enough damage. Fiend's Grip is going to come on the Queen of Pain. She's going to fall as well. Stun onto the Huskar. This has to be game. There's no buyback on any of those heroes. This is going to be top racks at the very least.
Yeah. Ember's still trying to hang on. But...
They want it. He's got the Searing Chains, but Zeros just don't care. It's not enough damage to threaten them. They have to earn to just tick them back up. They still have four charges on that. Guardian Greaves coming up in 5 seconds. There's no reason for this push to end.
Yeah. They even dropped the Orb of Venom. Someone did, anyway.
Dire's top barracks are under attack.
I don't even know whose that is, if it was BM or just, like, we have to put this down for some reason and...
Three-man stun!
Oh, no! Ember's down! That's game. Right?
And there's the... Yes, it's game. They're just not GG. This game is very over, Revo.
Maybe, I mean, they may be sitting in TeamSpeak talking about, I hope we're not going to get any, like, bad manners. Okay, there we go. Yeah.
They wanted to believe, and they decided that they just weren't as good as Agent Mulder.
Yeah. But there is a game number two, so there's a chance still for them to come back. I feel like it was still a drafting issue, and a early game issue. Even with those early kills on the Ember, I didn't actually like him going for the Boots of Travel. I felt like he was playing too passive against a team that wants to pressure him very early. You know what I mean?
I actually agree with the Boots of Travel choice, but I think they didn't give enough focus to getting that Queen of Pain some farm.
Yeah, Quap had nothing. She had a Yules at the end of the game, but at that point you're just saying, okay, I'm going to put myself up in the air, let Slardar walk up, and then stun me when I come down.
Pretty much. And game two, though. Yeah. It's coming. I think it should be coming pretty quick. The admins seem to like to move, so.
Yeah, and I like that. So we will be right back with the game. Of course, I'm SP Revolution 5, joined by Hippie Casting here on TrueSight TV. And we'll be right back with game number two. Thanks for watching.